Guardians, what is going on, guys? Sly here, back at it with another Forge video for you. And this time, we're talking about the Izanami Forge. So, as you guys can probably tell, my microphone is finally fixed. Comment down below if for some reason you can still only hear me out of one side of the headset. I'm hoping to Jesus that's not the case, but I did do a few test videos yesterday and I sent them out. So far, they were all good. Once again, sorry about all of that for the past few weeks. I'm sure listening to one side of the headset was stupidly annoying, but updating my BIOS along with changing a hidden setting on something that isn't even supposed to affect my microphone that ended up doing the trick. So hopefully all is well with that, because I delayed lots of videos because of that issue, because I didn't want people listening to just one side, you know, and making judgment because of that. Anyway, so enough about audio problems, let's get to the forge itself. So to unlock the Izanami Forge, guys, you first have to have the first two unlocked, Volunder and Gofanon. I have guides up about those if you need help here on my channel. Now, once you unlock the first two, you'll be ready to unlock the third. Head to Nessus, and then start wrangling some Vex. Eventually, one of them will drop you a white triangle, which then leads you on the longest, most tedious quest line Destiny 2 has ever released. And that's not like jokingly. I mean, seriously, guys, there's quest lines, you know, for fun new things to do in DLCs. And then there's the Izanami quest line. 100% nothing but fill in, fetch, busy work to the max, dude. I mean, it's terrible. I don't know who designed this, but damn, it's like some kind of... It's basically the Gofanon Forge line quest, but three times as long with twice the headshots. So you'll see when you get there, but it takes you a long time. Now, I would list the steps, but it's going to end up telling you where to go and what to do every step of the way, so there's no need for that. However, even with doing things as efficiently as possible, it still took me hours to unlock the forge. Hours, like seriously. And just a few hints for when you finally get there. Number one, Taken Blights. When you need to find Taken Blights, go to the fire base on Io. There are two right outside and then more down in the Wraith Mines. By the time you come back out, more will spawn. That's the fastest way to get the Blights done. Also, when it comes time to do the advanced version of the strike on Nessus, do not try to solo it. Save yourself a headache. It's a heroic strike level with Extinguish on, so if you die once you're back in orbit, that's terrible. Besides that, use a bow with Dragonfly for multi-kills and head over to Escalation Protocol on Mars. All that stuff I just said, it will make sense later. But once you get all that BS done, let's talk about the Forge itself. So first, strategy, weapons, then we'll go over how to get the third key for the mysterious box. As far as team makeup, doesn't really matter here as much as it did for the other forges. We're all much higher power level by now, and Wall of Radiance is no longer absolutely essential. However, still does come in handy quite a bit. For the forges, at least for this forge, it's all about clearing adds and not so much about damage, really, and I'll explain why in a second. So what you want to do here, guys, is go for add clearing supers. Stormcaller with the Tempest Hat, Arcstrider with Raiden Flux, or you can stick with Blade Barrage with the exotic arms. For Titan, Sentinel with Doomfang Pauldrons would be great for this activity, but once again, good old hammers are always hard to deny. You could also go Dawnblade for the Warlock, Bottom Tree, as well as Bottom Tree for Striker Titan, as there will be lots of enemies to extend your super. As for weapons, EP Shoddy still does awesome, but any Void Shotgun would work well here. For heavy, you're going to want to go with a sleeper. Now, as for strategy, there are a few things that you can do here. If you're decent enough and your team is pretty good, have your best player stay in the middle by the forge by themselves, and the other two are going to split off. One go left, one go right. As you drop the blue guys, chuck your batteries in the general direction of the forge. Maybe you'll get lucky and hit it, but more than likely you will not. Try to get them as close as possible to the forge so the middle guy can just pick them up and throw them in as he's running around, you know, killing enemies. The middle gets absolutely slammed with enemies. Lots of headless Vexes, Harpies, Cyclops, and Hydras both around the edges shooting towards the middle, and a few mix in right next to you. It gets rough in the middle, so having a good long-lasting super if you're the guy in the middle, that's a big deal. Now, eventually, as the two sides keep chucking batteries, orbs will start to pile up because the bottom sides are pretty easy down there with lots of enemies that drop orbs. So once you chuck over a bunch of orbs to the middle and you see that it's starting to pile up, go ahead, hit the man cannon, help out your middle buddy, clear up all of the adds, and help clear up the lying orbs. Then head back to your spot and repeat. That is the fastest way to get this done, as long as the middle guy can hold their ground. You get, like I said, you get slammed here, and being able to defend yourself while watching out for all these headless vexes and getting shot at and still picking up, you know, batteries and chucking them at the forge, that's a lot to handle. So some people can do it, some can't. But if you have a team that can, this is by far the fastest way to get these levels done. The other way is to keep two people in the middle and leave one side unattended. You will still have enough orbs and enemies to beat the countdown, but it's going to take you quite a bit longer. Again, if you're one of the lone guys out there on the platform by yourself, just chuck the batteries to the middle and one of the two in the middle will end up throwing it in, because you're just, there's really no way you can reliably hit the forge from those two platforms unless you climb all the way up top, but then you're just wasting a bunch of time. So as soon as you get a battery, chuck it to the middle, let the two in the middle decide how to get it into the forge itself. Now, moving on to the third key for the exotic box. Now, just like the others, you're going to have to make it to the second round, and again, look for two shield drones. One's going to spawn on each platform. So as you're looking towards the entrance, away from the forge, one spawns on the platform on the right, the other spawns on the platform on the left. The one on the right, it's going to spawn next to the man cannon on kind of like a broken kind of pillar, I guess you could say. The platform on the left, it spawns on the exact same side. The inner side closest to you. However, it's going to be the opposite corner, the corner closest to the entrance. Now, I have a couple of different shots here so you can see them from different areas. You see them spawn in right here, and I also have a different view so you get a better idea where to look at. Now, since you're going to be using sleeper here, you can't really snipe them, so it's best to break up and get two people involved. One for each side, because they do disappear rather fast, and if you're not fast enough, then of course that means you're going to miss it. These chests might have a larger purpose later on when we get, you know, deeper into this content update, but so far I've only seen them drop keys, and I've pretty much triggered this every time I've beaten a forge, just to see if anything else would happen. So not sure if anything else will pop out of this, but so far it doesn't look like it does. Okay, so next up, let's talk about the boss. Now, once you make it to the boss round, you're going to have to fight the same dude you did as the intro mission to unlock the forge, just like the others. You will see that these knobs are on the left and right side of the boss's shield. What you want to do here is shoot them, and this will cause the shields to rotate. Doing damage to these knobs makes the shield just rotate, you know, to the right-hand side. So shoot the knobs until the shield exposes the entire front side of the boss, and the shield is covering its entire back. Once that happens, break out sleeper and just watch him melt. Now, it's a little bit of cheating here, I guess, because if you get the shield to rotate like you see here, it does a complete, you know, 180, sleeper will hit for a critical, break up into 5 beams like it normally does, and then bounce off the shield and then back and hit the boss again. These reflecting shots destroy this dude very, very quickly. You can pretty much insta-melt this guy with a team of 3 sleepers. That's why you don't really need a Well of Radiance or any kind of long-term protection, because you can just melt this dude super fast. But it's important to make sure that shield is completely behind the boss. If it's only halfway to the side like you see here, it's not going to bounce and it won't do as much damage. So even though you'll still kill him and it'll still be easy, it's not going to be the instant melt you're looking for. But that's it, guys. Grab the chest, grab your loot, and then head back to 801 ASAP so you can start working towards getting the pulse rifle. I'm absolutely in love with the Black Armory Pulse Rifle Blast Furnace. It's pretty much like, go figure, a 4-burst pulse rifle, but the stats are just amazing as is. It's got super fast reload, way better handling, stability, recoil pattern, and if you get the right roll, it's going to absolutely wreck in Crucible. And with the stats being so good as is, it's going to be good regardless of perks. Even if you have terrible perks, it's still going to be a good weapon. So even though the unlock quest to get into the forge is horrible, it is absolutely worth it to get the pulse rifle. The bow's not too bad too, but a bow's a bow. When you shoot one, you pretty much shot them all. But that is about it, Nation. In some other forge news, the exotic bow is now dropping in the first 2 forges. Not sure about if it drops on the new one or not, but the secret to get the 3rd crest also slowly being cracked as we speak. It's pretty involved, and last time I checked, there were still some stumped guardians out there and a few more questions to unravel. However, as soon as it's figured out, I'll be on it. But that's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching and for supporting Sly Nation. Super glad to have this audio issue fixed, and thank you guys so much for your patience. I know it had to have been super annoying to listen out of one ear, and I'm sorry I couldn't figure it out sooner. I had everything set to stereo, and I used the exact same settings as my last PC, same audio programs, same recording programs, same microphone, same cables, same amp, everything. I mean, exact same setup. No idea why there was a problem to begin with. But I'm glad it's over. I'm glad it's fixed. Anyways, take care, guys, and keep those eyes open for more Destiny 2 Anthem and Division 2 videos coming out soon. But until then, this is your dude Sly, and I'll catch you guys next time.